Hello, good morning everyone, which one here, welcome back to the channel. When Laowa told me that they are going to release another new macro lens, I was really excited. But then they told me it is a full frame 85mm f5.6 2x macro lens, and I was really confused. Why are they releasing this lens as they already have an excellent 100mm 2x f2.8 macro lens? The Laowa 100mm f2.8 2x macro lens is one of the best macro lens that I've ever tested. The image quality is almost perfect. So isn't this new 85mm macro lens just too similar? And it's only f5.6 maximum aperture. That's really slow, like two stops slower. But by the time that I receive this lens, I understand why, and that is the tiny size of this 85mm 2x macro lens. This Laowa 85mm 2x macro lens is so much smaller than the Laowa 100mm 2x macro lens. Let's do some comparison of these two 2x macro lens and see how does this new Laowa 85mm lens performs when we compare it with the excellent Laowa 100mm 2x macro lens. This Laowa 85mm 2x macro lens is a fully mechanical manual focus lens, unlike the 100mm 2x macro lens, which was originally designed for DSLR cameras and then adapted for mirrorless cameras. This new Laowa 85mm lens is designed for mirrorless camera with short French distance. It is available for Nikon Z, Canon RF, and also Sony E Mark. It is also available for Leica M Mark as well. The Leica M Mark version has rangefinder coupling, but remember the M Mark rangefinder does have a 0.7m close focus limit, so you have to switch over to use the live view when you are taking macro photos. When I'm working on this review, there is no L Mark version available yet, but I heard that the L Mark version will be coming quite soon. So I put a link below to the Laowa's official website so you can check the latest information about this lens. The first thing I really want to talk about this lens is the size and weight of this lens. It is a really small macro lens for full frame cameras. It is much, much smaller than the Laowa 100mm 2x macro lens. You can see the huge difference in terms of size between these two lenses. And despite it has a full metal construction, the weight of this lens is only around 240 grams. So pretty lightweight lens, and it is like less than 40% the weight of the Laowa 100mm macro lens. Remember, Laowa created a pretty tiny 50mm 2x macro lens for Micro Four Thirds cameras not too long ago. This 85mm full frame lens is pretty much exactly the same size as that Micro Four Thirds lens, and it is only 10 grams or so heavier, so that's pretty amazing. Because the diameter of this lens is so small, so for the Nikon Z and also the Canon RF version, since these two lens mounts are quite big, so the lens actually would expand out a bit near the lens mount. We have the mechanical aperture ring at the front of the lens. It has clicks and it is one click per stop. The aperture ring feels very nice. And then we have the manual focus ring behind it. The focus throw is about 135 degrees and the focus ring feels super smooth. This is an internal focus lens as well, so the length of the lens doesn't change when you change the focus distance, so that is great. If you have watched my Laowa 100mm 2x macro lens review, you may remember I complained about the front of that 100mm macro lens is completely exposed when you adjust the focus to infinity side. So if you don't use the supplied UV filter, dust and dirt could get inside the lens quite easily. This time, with this Laowa 85mm lens, Laowa has put a glass element that completely sealed the front of the lens. So even when you change the focus distance to infinity, there wouldn't be an exposed area at the front, so dust couldn't get in so easily. One interesting thing I noticed is the focus ring on this Laowa 85mm macro lens turns the opposite direction if you compare it with the Laowa 100mm macro lens. With this 85mm lens, you turn clockwise to change the focus to close focus. With the 100mm macro lens, you turn the focus ring counterclockwise to change focus to close distance. The lens comes with a metal lens hood that is very small, very cute, and it fits onto the lens very nicely, very securely, and it is also reversible as well. However, I do find there is one usability issue. If you reverse the lens hood, maybe you just take the lens out from the camera bag, then the lens hood does completely block the aperture ring, so you cannot change the aperture value, or you cannot even check what is the aperture setting that you have set on the lens until you remove the lens hood. Now, of course, this is not a unique problem for this lens. A lot of lenses have the same issue, but it could still be a problem for some users. Apart from its compact size, the biggest selling point of this 85mm macro lens is its 2x maximum magnification ratio. If you have never shot with a 2x macro lens before, here is a set of comparison photos. You can see there is a big difference between what you can capture with a normal 1x and a 2x macro lens. When shooting at 2x magnification, there is approximately 6.5cm between the front of the lens and your subject. That is not bad at all, and because the diameter of the lens is quite small, so you won't cast shadow on your subject quite as easy as some other macro lens which has a bigger diameter. For example, the Lauer 100mm 2x macro lens has a slightly longer distance between the subject and the front of the lens when you are taking 2x macro photos, but because the lens has a bigger diameter, so overall the Lauer 85mm lens is slightly better if you want to avoid casting shadow or if you want to light up the subject using external light source. When taking photo at normal non-macro distance, the center sharpness of this 85mm lens is already excellent at f5.6. Because of that, stopping down the lens makes virtually no difference in terms of center sharpness. With my 24mm Nikon Z6, the center sharpness remains excellent until f16 when diffraction starting to make the image slightly softer. If we compare it with the Lauer 100mm 2x macro lens, at f5.6, the center sharpness is excellent with both lenses and I can't really see any difference. And now let's have a look at the corner. With the Lauer 85mm lens, at f5.6, the corner is already pretty sharp. I don't see any color fringing and contrast is great. When stopping down the lens to f8, the corner sharpness would improve slightly. The Lauer 100mm lens has excellent corner sharpness at f5.6, so it's really really sharp at f5.6. It's sharper than the 85mm lens at the same aperture, even though the Lauer 85mm is not bad at all. Now let's have a look at the sharpness when we are taking macro photo at 2x magnification and see if we get any different results. The center of the Lauer 85mm lens is already very sharp again at f5.6. And if I compare it with the 100mm lens at f5.6, the 100mm lens appears to be even sharper. The Lauer 100mm is a really really sharp lens, so even when I shoot at f4 or even f2.8, the center is still incredibly sharp as well. There's virtually no difference between shooting at f2.8 to f5.6 with the Lauer 100mm lens. And now let's have a look at the corner when taking 2x macro photos. With the 85mm Lauer lens, at f5.6, corner is reasonably sharp as well. To be honest, I don't really know why you would care too much about corner sharpness at this kind of magnification unless you are using the lens to scan some film negative or doing something similar. But even if you do, I think you'll be pretty happy with the corner sharpness with this Lauer 85mm lens at f5.6. Stopping down the lens to f8 and you do get a bit improvement in terms of corner sharpness. Compare the Lauer 85mm lens with the Lauer 100mm lens. The 100mm lens does have better corner sharpness at f5.6. With the 100mm lens, the corner is very sharp even at f4. Only when shooting at the maximum aperture f2.8, I noticed there's a very slight drop in corner sharpness, but it is still pretty sharp. With the f5.6 maximum aperture on the Laowa 85mm lens, you usually wouldn't dissolve the background too much when taking non-macro photos. However, once your subject is within 1 meter distance, the lens can start to dissolve the background quite a bit. Sometimes I see a bit of onion pattern in the bokeh balls from the Laowa 85mm lens, which makes the bokeh look a bit nervous. Luckily, this isn't always noticeable. Another thing I noticed is, as soon as I stop down the Laowa 85mm lens from f5.6 to f8, the bokeh balls would already turn into heptagon shape. With the Laowa 100mm lens, one thing you need to notice is, while the different versions for the different lens mount, they have the same optical design, the aperture braid design is different. The Nikon F version that I used to do my original review only has 7 aperture braids, and this is the same as the Laowa 85mm lens. While the Nikon Z mount version that I bought later on, and also the other mirrorless version, they all have the 13 aperture braid design. So with my Nikon Z version of the Laowa 100mm lens, the bokeh balls would remain round even if I stop down the lens quite a bit. With the Laowa 85mm lens, there is a small amount of vignetting at the maximum aperture f5.6. Stopping down the lens would gradually reduce the amount of vignetting, but even at f5.6, vignetting is really not bad at all. Compare it with the Laowa 100mm lens. At f5.6, the Laowa 100mm lens has less vignetting. There's virtually no vignetting at all at f5.6. But it's because the 100mm lens is a f2.8 lens. So at f5.6, you already stop down by 2 stop already. If we look at the Laowa 100mm lens at its maximum aperture f2.8, then there is quite a bit of vignetting. When checking my vignetting test results, I noticed there is a bit of difference in terms of colors from the two Laowa lenses, even though I set the camera to the same white balance setting and using the same lighting. So I shot another pair of test photos, also with the same white balance and same lighting. So it appears the two lenses, they do have slightly different color rendering. The Laowa 100mm lens renders the image slightly warmer with a little bit more red tint. While it's not really a huge difference, you should be able to see it in this set of side-by-side comparison photos. Laowa called this 85mm macro lens an APO or APO lens, just like their 100mm macro lens. What it means is, the lens should have excellent chromatic aberration control and it should have very minimal amount of color fringing. If you look at these sample photos that I shot around midday on a bright sunny day using the Laowa 85mm lens at the maximum aperture, even the high contrast area, I see virtually no color fringing. So this is very impressive. If you look at these local test photos, the amount of longitudinal chromatic aberration is at a pretty low level, even at the maximum aperture for both lenses. Distortion is usually not really that important for a macro lens, not when you are shooting macro photos anyway. But let's have a look at whether these lenses have any distortion if you are taking non-macro photos. Look at this brick wall test photo that shot with the Laowa 85mm lens. There really isn't much distortion at all. Maybe a little bit of barrel distortion, but it's really minor. And now let's have a look at this test photo that shot with the Laowa 100mm lens. There's also quite minor amount of distortion, maybe a little bit more than the Laowa 85mm lens. And interestingly, with the Laowa 100mm lens, we have pink cushion distortion instead. When I shoot directly into the sun at the maximum aperture, there's some lens flare with the Laowa 85mm lens. I won't say this is terrible, but it is definitely very noticeable. Another thing is, when the sun is just outside the frame, there is a particular angle that there will suddenly be large amount of lens flare. Unfortunately, the supplied lens hood doesn't seem to help reduce this particular kind of lens flare. The Lauer 100mm lens also has quite a bit of lens flare, and overall I think the lens flare from the Lauer 100mm lens is very similar to the Lauer 85mm lens. When stopping down the lens, the Lauer 85mm lens can render 14 Pon sun stars from its 7 aperture brace. But to get some nice and sharp sun stars, you really have to stop down the lens to f16 or f22. But now, if we look at the sun stars with the Lauer 100mm lens at f22, the sun stars from the Lauer 100mm lens looks really messy, and I definitely don't like it. Comparing the image quality of this new Lauer 85mm macro lens with the Lauer 100mm macro lens, I think both are really good lenses, and there are pros and cons with each of these lenses. But I feel the Lauer 100mm macro lens deliver slightly better image quality overall. And to be honest, I was completely expecting this and not really surprised by the results. The Lauer 85mm macro lens was created with a very specific and different reason. Lauer wants to create a 2x full frame macro lens, but not just a typical 2x macro lens as they already created one. This time, they want to create a lens that is much, much smaller and much lighter, so it is very easy to carry around. For Lauer to achieve this goal, there will be some compromises. And I'm quite surprised, there is actually very little amount of compromises in terms of image quality. The lens is almost as good as Lauer's 100mm 2x macro lens, and this is not really an easy task because the 100mm macro lens is a fantastic lens, and you now want to shrink the lens to such a smaller size. So the biggest compromise is that it is just a f5.6 lens, unlike the Lauer 100mm lens or most other macro lens in the market that usually has the f2.8 maximum aperture. It may sound like a huge compromise, but it's not. And I actually think it is a very clever idea. If you are buying a macro lens for shooting macro only, f5.6 is perfectly fine. I think I have never shot any real world macro photo at f2.8 or f4. Even my sharpness test photo that I shot at f2.8, I still struggle quite a bit because the depth of field is just so narrow that I quite often have to repeat my test photos many times to make sure my results are perfectly in focus. So when I shoot my real world macro photos, it's usually at least f8 and most of the time even smaller aperture. So having a f5.6 macro lens has zero impact on what I can actually capture. It's only when you want to use this lens as a portrait lens, for example, then f5.6 could be a disadvantage as you can't really separate the subject from the background that easily. Some of you may know that I am a wedding photographer, and for each wedding, there are at least one or two macro photos that I need to capture. Usually it's the ring shot, but while my Lauer 100mm 2x macro lens is my best macro lens, I rarely would bring it with me when I'm shooting weddings, and I usually would just pick one of my other smaller, lighter macro lens instead. It's just because I want to make my camera bag a little bit lighter as I'm already carrying too many gears. If I've bought this Lauer 85mm macro lens, then I'm quite sure this would be the macro lens that I take with me to every wedding instead. Losing a little bit of corner sharpness, or the bokeh is not quite as smooth or as round, usually it's not really that noticeable in the final photo. But my shoulder would fan me a lot for carrying a lighter camera bag, especially shooting weddings. They are usually 8 to 12 hours long. If you want the best image quality, the Lauer 100mm 2x macro lens is still the better choice. But the best macro lens is the macro lens that you have with you. That's exactly what this Lauer 85mm 2x macro lens is.